All right, today you might be bored on server power supplies. If you don't own any of these, feel free to stop watching now, but you might still learn something. I want to cover, because I was just watching some more older live streams from even the big boys like Red Panda Mining, and nobody seems to point out the fact that there are two very different models of 1200 watt HP server power supplies. One of them is 80 plus platinum, and the other one is 80 plus silver. And right here, I have one of each, so you can see just how insanely difficult this is to tell apart, and how most people are probably running the silver power supplies, running 50 watts more power consumption just in heat in their power supply without even knowing the difference. So, how to spot the difference? It is pretty simple. The dead giveaway, if the power supply has not been messed with, is the fan. So the silvers will either have an unbranded Nidec fan label, or they will say 1200W. The platinums will have a fan grill, and they'll say 1200, and they'll have 94% on them as well. Another way to tell is the silvers do have PD11 written on them, and the other platinum power supplies will either have PD19 or any of the PL designations. So you can tell by the model number as well, but a lot of times online, sellers are just pulling random photos from the internet, and you're like, well, I don't know. It looks like a platinum, probably a platinum. I've even heard people say, well, it's got the blue power plug, so it's a platinum. Not necessarily, because these are both platinum power supplies, and one has a blue cord, one has a black cord. So it doesn't make any difference. They're both PLCs. I'm not sure, but I'm going to show you just how significant the power consumption difference is between these with my only four spare GPUs, so I'll get the power load as high as I can, but I'm going to run the main board here just off this ATX power supply. It's going to be completely divorced from the power meter, which runs on this plug. We are going to be operating at 120 volts. The end result, maybe I'll put on 240 as well, just so you can see the difference there, but there is a significant difference in efficiency and power consumption between these two models, and I just want to make sure you guys know not to buy the silvers. The silvers suck. The platinums are really good. Okay, we have an RX 474 gig, an RX 574 gig, an RX 5600 XT 6 gig, and a Vega 56 8 gig, all plugged into one of the platinum HP power supplies. I'm not going to bother with anything crazy as far as linking them together. You can trigger the HP server power supplies off of an ATX, but for the sake of this test, I'm just going to run them separately. We can see that we are indeed fired up. Let me get it into Hive, remove all the overclocks, so these are running at full tilt. Let me throw them on Ravencoin or something super high power, and let's see what the at-the-wall power usage is for these four cards without the main system on the platinum power supply at 110 volts. Okay, platinum power supply, 110, mining Neoxa on Kapow. We are pulling 729 watts at the wall. 730, 731. All right, so I just switched over to the silver. That's it. It went from 730 to 769. That is a 40 watt difference. That's the only difference. Garbage. Okay, I just ran all of my platinums through the same workload, and honestly, you can kind of bin these too. So I've got a 729, a 738, a 730, and on the bench right now is a 732. And I've just switched it over to 240 volts on my PDU through a smart plug. So the meter readings won't be quite the same. That's why I'm gonna run this power supply again, A, to see how accurate it is, and then B, this is on 240, so we should see a lower number anyway, even with the same load. So I'm really curious to see what this ends up pulling. After that, we'll throw a silver in there and we'll get a better idea for all of the efficiency differences between the silver and the platinum. Okay, so the same load that was doing 732 on 110 is doing 689. So we'll call it 690. I'm gonna shut it back down. We'll run the silver through it, and then I'm gonna run all the other power supplies through this as well, just so I have, you know, kind of a decent idea of what this is actually pushing through. But I'm curious to see if maybe the silvers are less bad on 240 than they are on 110. Not entirely sure. All right, so the silver is back on with 240. and you can see the magnitude difference on the platinum and the two silvers. It's significant. However, I will say on 240, it's only a 20 watt difference versus a 40 on 110. So they are significantly better on 240 than they are on 110, but still the worst result for a platinum on 110 was still like 30 watts better than the best result of a silver on 240. So these things are absolute junk. It's a 40 watt difference at 650 watts of load on 110, or it's about a 20 to 25, maybe 30 watt difference between the two on 240 for that same load. But I know a lot of people that run these at significantly higher than that load wise, so you might be looking at 50 watts or more difference just going away in heat in the power supply if you're using these in a residential setting. So I have to reiterate once again, make sure you're buying platinums, because there are plenty of people out there advertising these silvers for about 20 bucks and you can get a platinum for the same price. So just don't be stupid, do a little bit of research and make sure you're buying the platinum version. Just to quick sum up, you have the silvers on the left and the platinums on the right. You can pause it real quick if you want to see, but I put on the exact same DC load their wall wattage at 120 and 240, and you can see there is a very significant difference. However, this silver is particularly junk. Look at that, 110 or 120, it's 770 watts. 754 on this, that's only a 25 watt difference. So your mileage may vary, but even at 20 watts, that's like running an entire 6600 on Caspa, just in heat in the power supply. And there's effectively no price difference between these two. You just have to make sure you're getting these and not these.